In this video, we are going to show our new version of Acolor Manager. To use this version, you need to install Office Studio Tools all-in-one application from our website or links in the video description. Then to open the tool, go to App Store menu, Office Studio Tools submenu, and select Acolor Manager option. From this dialog, if you are using V-Ray as your render, you can convert your scene from standard sRGB color space to ASUS CG wider color space. This file is using the default V-Ray 5 render settings, and if we render the selected view, we can see how the scene look in the standard sRGB space. The default V-Ray render looks good, but the colors in the shadows are not all that natural, and there is not much depth in the scene. We can try to fix that by adding some V-Ray frame buffer adjustments. For example, we can apply filmic tone map and adjust the sliders until we are happy with the result. We can even add more layers like color balance or others, but this usually takes time, and you need to be very experienced with the color correction to achieve good results. With our new tool, you can convert the scene to ASUS CG color space and make this color adjustments a lot faster by rendering the scene in closer to real world, wider color space. To convert the scene, just press Convert Scene to ASUS CG button and wait until all the materials are converted, and 3ds Max updates the viewport materials. Now the conversion is complete. To compare with the original render, we can use this image. On the right, we have the same original image, but with applied custom lookup table. Let's render the converted scene, and see how image calculated in ASUS CG is compared to standard V-Ray render. We can see that the oranges look a lot more natural, and there is more depth in the scene. We do not need to do a lot more to correct this image. All our textures are currently in sRGB color space, but in real life we have a lot more colors. With Acolor Manager, we can mix any texture to any value between sRGB and ASUS CG color space. For example, to change the color space of this wall, all we need to do is to select it and press Convert Selection to ASUS CG. In the list above the button, we can see all the color textures used for the material of the wall. By selecting any of the textures and then using the slider below the list, you can blend the colors to any value between sRGB and ASUS CG. If we render again, we can see how the diffuse texture of the wall looks in ASUS CG color space. The colors are a lot more vibrant, and if we do not like it, we can move the slider to sRGB color space or choose any position in between. Next render will show 50% blend between sRGB and ASUS CG. If we want, we can do the same adjustment for the oranges by selecting them in the scene and pressing Convert Selection button. Here we can select all diffuse textures for the oranges and move the slider to the left. Let's see the result. With these values, the oranges does not look so good, but to fix that, we can simply move the slider closer to sRGB color space. And let's render the final result. To modify the environment map in Acolor Manager dialog, we need to deselect all objects and press Convert Selection button. In the new pop-up window, press Yes button to process the environment map. This way we have access to all textures used for the scene environment. Mixing sRGB and ASUS CG colors is only optional and should be only used when we cannot achieve the desired look with simpler methods. In the second part of this video, we are going to explain all options and settings for Acolor Manager tool. The first group of parameters is display correction. Here we can set how to display the rendered image in V-Ray frame buffer. We can use three LUTs, base, bright and dark. The bright LUT will brighten the image and will add more saturation and contrast. The dark LUT will darken the image, and again will add more saturation and contrast. Only the first base LUT is correct to ASUS CG workflow, the other two are additional looks you can try for your renders. The first two display options are using OCO configuration, which you need to download and configure separately for your system. Check the V-Ray documentation on Chaos website to learn how to do that. After you select any of these options, you can see but the frame buffer is updated immediately. If configured correctly, the OCO options will be indistinguishable with the base LUT. The last option is None, and it will reset the V-Ray display correction to the default values. To completely disable all corrections, you can manually select the first option in the frame buffer's display correction. For this scene, we are going to use our base LUT, as this makes it easier and faster to save the rendered images. Now, we only need to specify the file name. We recommend saving all files with 16-bit per channel, as ASUS CG color space have a lot more information, and in 8-bit, some of it could be lost. If we use OCO configuration, when saving the image, we have to remember to overwrite the gamma to 1.0. If we don't set it manually, the saved file will be incorrect and too bright. The next group of options is the material correction. Here we can specify how to do the conversion of all V-Ray materials from sRGB to ASUS CG color space. By default, we are using an OSL map, which is linked to a file in the Acolor Manager Tools folder. There is also an option to bake the OSL source code in the map and never worry about missing external files. We have the same two options with V-Ray OSL texture map. The top two options are to use OCO map for the material conversion with environment or local file. The last option is for when we want to remove any of the previous conversions and reset scene materials. In the text field below, we can set the path to custom OSL local file. In the next multiline text field, you can add your custom OSL code for the corresponding option. The last parameter for this group is the default mix value set in the OSL map. Value of 1.0 will set the color space of the textures to sRGB. Value of 0.0 will set the color space of the textures to ASUS CG. Any value in between will mix the sRGB and ASUS CG colors. In the next parameter, the OCO custom config text field, you can specify the path to local OCO config file. Below that, we have some general tools options. The first one is to update the mix value of the existing Acolor Manager OSL maps. The second is to update the code or path of the existing Acolor Manager OSL maps. The third is to fix a bug when rendering HDR textures on GPU in combination with OSL maps. The last option is to automatically set the V-Ray color management in the render setup dialog. We recommend to leave this option turned on. This is the most important option, as if not set correctly, the rendered result will be also incorrect. At the bottom right, we have the information for the last conversion. These are all the parameters for our new tool. We hope you find this short demonstration useful. If you get so far, please consider liking, commenting, and sharing this video. Thank you for watching.